for you.
Thank you. Well, good afternoon for us. Good morning. So I'm gonna present a work that we titled Design of a Wheel-Leg Robot. And these are the authors, Luis, Victor, Manuel, and myself, Jose Luis. We are from Faculty of Engineering, Universidad Tecnológica Centroamericana in Honduras, with collaboration with Universidad Don Bosco in El Salvador. These are the chapters that will be reviewing this presentation. First, the introduction, then a theory. The theory we are trying to develop, and some of the method for building the prototype, analysis and results and conclusions. So let's start here with the introduction. The design that we are going to present here in this presentation, it's taking the task of mobile robots that use legs. These are very interesting robots that can be used for more complex tasks like going upstairs or working in irregular terrains. So the main purpose is to improve accessibility and mobility in complex architectural environments by implementing this robot. This is a very low cost robot. Now let's see a little bit of the theory. Well, this is based on legs design for climbing upstairs. So this is a paper we published last year about how the robots should go upstairs by relating their leg opening. This is the leg. And here we have an opening between the legs. So we try to relate this opening with the dimensions of the obstacle. In this case, the dimension we were relating was the diagonal that the upstairs have. So when we relate them and we make like 64 simulations, we conclude that there was a constant of 1.3 where the simulations got success with a better behavior. So we try to apply this now for a robot that can move in complex terrains. And we also, when we have the opening we need, we can also have the wheel diameter that will be the diameter of the whole wheel. And this wheel depends on the number of legs that we want to have. With a higher number of legs, we will have a bigger diameter. And we also try to see the distance between the centers of the wheels with this formula. These are experimental formulas we were using. And now the methodology or the method we use for building the robot, first the design in SolidWorks, where we make some simulations also about the robot behavior. Then we use very low cost materials like aluminum parts and 3D printing. We cut them and we ensemble it in a prototype, small prototype, and we add the electronic system. So this robot has four motors, DC motors that moves these wheels that have four legs. So for the movement, it is need a big torque because of the opening of the leg, so that something has to be taken consideration. And now let's see the results about this project. So first the robot design. Basically, it has the four DC motors that we can see here in the structure, an electronic system to control these that will be teleoperated by a PlayStation control, two servo motors to have an orientation and add more degrees of freedom, a gear mechanism to increase the torque. The torque is one of the tasks that the robot needs to develop so the wheels can move. And basically, this is the structure we test. Then we have this diagram connection. We teleoperate the robot using this PlayStation control via Bluetooth. This communicates with a ESP32 we have here as the master control. We use a MPU5060 so we can see how the center of mass of the robot behaves. Then we have a Arduino that controls the four speed controllers for the motors. These are DC motors that receive a PWM signal. And we also have the servo motors that controls the orientation of the robot. This goes to a 12 volts battery so the robot can move. Finally, we start seeing that our prototype has a lot of vibrations. So we start to see how we can damp some of the vibrations. So this is a PLA leg wheel. So we try to have a complete TPU leg wheel, but there was not as strong for the application. So we add this. This is a damping additional part that we add to the leg. And what we see when we add this damping solution, that here we have just the PLA wheel, and here we have the TPU damping additional part, that the noise and the movement of the center of mass is more stable using the damping. So damping works very good. And then we make some test performance. We try it in different environments. We try it in grass, in sand, upstairs, and in some ramps with a very small inclination to see how this robot behaves. And finally, I have here a 1 minute video so you can see some of the tasks that robot did. This is in sand. We try to put some obstacles in sand, putting some amount of sand in some places. This is the final prototype. We also tested in this environment. It's a I think this one is easier because it's more, there is no obstacles to pass, but we can also prove that our orientation system was working correct. It moves with no problem in grass also. And the obstacles here were small. We also prove it in some stairs. And for conclusion, The study process several techniques approaches to overcome mobility problems on stairs, from track robots to innovative planetary geo designs. Each approach offers specific solutions tailored to different environments. Adaptability and versatility are key aspects in the design of a climbing robot, and a damping comparison was made when replacing PLA rims with TPU, and higher level of damping with TPU was observed. And finally, just thank you for your time.
Thank you very much for your presentation. It's also interesting.